Great, so we know how to define classes and create instances. We don't know how to do anything useful with them yet. So that's what we're going to learn next. We're going to learn about attributes. If we want to do something more interesting with our classes, we need to add attributes to them. And in Python, we can do that very simply. We can use the object followed by a dot, followed by a name. This is the name of the attribute. And if we want to create a new attribute or update an old one, we can use assignment. So we can assign that to some value. What this does is it sets the value associated with the attribute name for the object here to be whatever this expression evaluates to. So let me show you an example. So here we've created an instance of the restaurant class. It has no attributes yet, but we can add one. Using the syntax, we're adding an attribute name and giving it the value of the string, McDowell's Burger Emporium. And now we can use that attribute. Note that adding an attribute doesn't create a new object, it just adds attributes to that object. So we already had our restaurant object that was created when we did this. We had a new instance of it and we labeled it McDowell's. Now we've taken that object and we've added an attribute name to it and we've given it some value. Notice that if we create a new restaurant instance, this is creating a new object and we're assigning it to the name Shea Bananas. So the Shea Bananas object does not have a name attribute. If we try to look for it, we'll get an error. We get an attribute error that says this restaurant object has no attribute named name. We can add one. Now we've added a name attribute to Shea Bananas, and it's this long string. That didn't change the name of McDowell's. They're separate objects with separate names. We can, of course, add other attributes. So we can add, say, an owner, add another attribute, and we'll also add a chef attribute. These didn't change anything about the object that Shea Bananas points to. Just to confirm, Shea Bananas still has no chef. Just like any other name, we can change what a name refers to, so we can change what an attribute refers to. We'll do that just with an assignment. So suppose Chef Queasy was fired. We have a new chef at McDonald's. We have Chef Hurl. And that'll change the value associated with this name. Now the chef attribute points to the string Chef Hurl. Sounds very yummy to me. We can define functions that work on our objects. Let's define a display restaurant function. And it's going to take a restaurant as input. And all it will do is print the name of the restaurant. So let's try that. We'll call display restaurant, passing in the object McDowell's refers to, which has the name McDowell's something or other. We can do the same thing with the object Shea Bananas refers to.